Amen.
Hallelujah.
At this time, I'm going to say a prayer. Lord, in our heavenly Father, Father, we give you all honor. We give you all praise, Lord. Father, I pray that this prayer would just be present with us today. Pour out your heart, Father. Help us to come to our hearts. Waiting and waiting and waiting for the great things in our lives. And we enjoy doing great things for you. We pray, O Lord, they're going to be led by the pastor, and while they're doing our reverend will give us the scripture reading, which will be taken from Ezekiel chapter 1, verses 1 to 5.
Reading verses 1 through 5. Afterward,
he brought me to the gate, even the gate that looked toward the east. And behold, the glory of the God of Israel came from the way of the east. And his voice was like a voice of many waters, and the earth shone with his glory. And it was according to the appearance of the vision which I saw, when I came to destroy the city. And the vision were like the vision that I saw by the servant's heart, and I fell upon my face. And the glory of the Lord came into the house by the way of the gate, whose prospect is toward the east. So the Spirit took me up and brought me into the inner court, and behold, the glory of the Lord filled the house.
Which was the reading of God's word.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is good.
Before we get into the worship, we should thank God that we are alive,
and we are still here.
Not matter what is happening in your life, it does not matter what is going on. He's still Jehovah Jireh. He's still Jehovah Nissiah. He's still Jehovah Sabaoth. He's still the El Elyon. He's still the great I Am. He's still the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Hallelujah, 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 Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God is worthy. God is worthy. You know, sometimes challenges come and we tend to give up. But God is still worthy this morning. Hallelujah. As we welcome you here, both in physical and online, we want to start off by singing that song, "Oh Christian, look up and be joyful."
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, Christian, look up and be joyful. Look and in every bind. Though trials may sometimes oppress thee, oh, think on a Savior's mind. Look up, oh, the turbulent sea. Lo, thy Redeemer is coming to thee. Oh, let thy heart like that water. Bow to His will. Oh, Christian, look up and be joyful. The gloom that darkens the sky, the clouds that are frowning above thee, will melt at the glance of the eye. Look up, oh, the turbulent sea. Lo, thy Redeemer is coming. Look up, oh, the turbulent sea. Look, I read.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Fervently.
Hallelujah.
Lovingly.
Bow
to his will.
Hallelujah.
You see, it doesn't matter who you are. The devil had to bow. His demons had to bow. So it doesn't matter who you are. You have to bow before the living God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Every sickness, every trial, every challenge, every temptation must bow before the living God. He is the only one in this world that has dunamis power. He's the only one in this world that can transform us. Hallelujah. And when we have look up, then we can sing, open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. What do we want to do? We want to see you. We want to see your power. We want to see your authority in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Holy, 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 holy
your power and love as we sing, holy, 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 holy. I want to see you. I want to see you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
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 If we would sometimes just see God and not problems, life would just be so easier. You see, Hallelujah. So very often we focus on problems, we focus on the sickness, we focus on all these challenges, and all God is saying, just see me in the midst of these challenges.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Just see me in the midst of these challenges.
Yes.
We need a push pass. We need a push pass.
Hallelujah.
And we need a press in.
Yes.
Because that is the only way we're going to get the victory.
Hallelujah.
That's the only way. That's why we can continue by singing. Oh, I want to see him. Look upon his face. There to sing forever of his saving grace.
On
the streets of glory, let me lift my voice.
Cares
all pass. Home at last. Ever to rejoice.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
I journey through the land, singing as I go, pointing souls to Calvary from the crimson flow. Many arrows pierce my soul from within, but my Lord.
Look upon his face. Because God is with us.
Hallelujah.
Because we want to see Him. We're going to do that song, Lord, I thirst for you.
Glory.
And then as we thirst, we need God in the midst of this situation.
Yes.
You see, people are only looking at COVID, but there are other situations beyond that. And we need God to take us through before He return on this earth. There's some purpose that need to be accomplished. Yes. There's some young people that need to be saved.
Hallelujah.
There's some marriages that need deliverance.
Yes.
So we need to thirst for the Lord. And then we're going to go before His throne this morning. Hallelujah. Lord, I thirst for you. I want you to just lock in this morning.
Lord, I thirst for you. your holiness.
Lord, I thirst.
Lord, I thirst for you. I long to be in your presence. My soul will wait for you. Father, draw me nearer. Draw me nearer to the beauty of your home.
Start to pray, because we have to believe. If we don't believe in the power of God, then other people can't believe in the power of God. If you need healing this morning, bring it to your mind. If you need financial blessing, then bring it to your mind. If you're praying for a family member, then bring it to your mind. If you're praying for your marriage, then bring it to mind.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, we have to believe in the power of God.
Hallelujah.
We have to believe in it. Because this is the only way that people will see that God is real.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Restore Jesus. Anoint Jesus.
Almighty God, in the beauty of your holiness.
Let's do that one more time for the Lord. Lord, I thirst.
Lord, I thirst for you.
Yeah.
I long to be in your presence. My soul will wait on you. Father, draw me nearer. Draw me nearer to the beauty of your
beauty of your holiness.
In the beauty of your holiness. In the beauty of your holiness. In the beauty of your holiness. In the beauty of your holiness.
Hallelujah. If you need to rededicate your life to the Lord this morning,
hallelujah,
this is the time.
Hallelujah.
This is
thank
the time
you,
to do it.
You,
this is the time to do it. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is the time to seek his face.
Hallelujah.
This is the time to seek his face.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
Hallelujah.
And all these things will be added unto us.
Hallelujah.
You see, the requirement is seek. We need to seek. We need to seek. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, we give you thanks and we give you praise this morning, God.
Thank you for your mindfulness.
Father God, you are worthy and you are worthy of all our praises, God. Father God, there is none under this heaven that we can worship, we can praise, we can adore, we can magnify. Lord, this morning we come before you, God, and we raise our voice in adoration to you, God. We say, mighty God, come among us and do what you will, mighty God. Father God, have your way. Have your way, have your way, have your way, have your way, God.
Give us, Lord, the encouragement.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
There are some of you that was on the brink of giving up.
Hallelujah.
And the Holy Spirit is saying, just hold on.
Yes.
Just hold on a little bit longer.
Thank you, Jesus.
He knows that you have been going through challenges. He knows that you have been going through difficulties.
Hallelujah.
But he's saying, just hold on, just hold on.
Hallelujah.
And we'll just hold on the cross. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God is indeed worthy.
Yes, he is.
God is indeed worthy. Hallelujah. God, you're worthy, you're worthy, God. You're worthy, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
us,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You see, we need
us,
to
Lord.
Understand his
breathe
power.
Upon us, hey, hey, hey,
Jesus, Jesus.
Anoint us afresh, Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, 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 Lord God.
Break through, Lord. Hallelujah.
Allow
hallelujah.
The Holy Spirit to break through.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Allow the Holy Spirit to give you deliverance.
Hallelujah.
Allow the Holy Spirit to get involved in your situation.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Let me see your shape.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank
we have
Lord.
To understand that there is more with us than with the enemy.
Amen. Hallelujah.
When we understand that angels are surrounding us.
Hallelujah.
You see, when we pray, we start to cultivate an atmosphere. And God is in the atmosphere.
Yes.
God is in the wind. God is in the wind. And we have to cultivate that. You can't put your trust in other leaders. The onus body, the word of God says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not.
Hallelujah.
We need to trust him this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we do this final song, standing on the promises of God, if you have not put in your tithes and offerings, just follow the usher's direction as they lead you to put in your tithes and offerings this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Christ my King. Through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God.
Oh, I am
standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Promises of God.
I am
standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, standing. I am standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises I now can see. Perfect.
Standing on the promises of God.
Bless your name, Lord.
You see, the third verse says, standing on the promises I now can see. Perfect, present, cleansing in the blood for me. Standing in the liberty where Christ makes me free.
Hallelujah.
Standing on the promises
Thank
of God.
You, Jesus.
If we can understand freedom, we can understand living. Because where there is freedom, you can live effectively. When freedom is not present, then you're going to live in bondage and slavery. Now at this time, we're going to ask our dear superintendent, Reverend Hope, to ask God's blessing on the tithes and offerings.
Father, we give you thanks, we give you praise, we give you honor, we give you glory. You indeed are worthy of our praises from the rising of the sun unto the going down thereof. We thank you for these offerings. We give you thanks for everyone who has been able to give. And those who have not, we pray, God, that you will open doors. We pray that you will make provision that they themselves will be able to labor and to earn and give to your service. Jesus. Take thanks for your blessing. Take thanks for your provision. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. I thank you. God bless you. And now I turn back over to our dear sister, Marcia.
Our worship team, and at this time we're going to have the prayer and rededication by our Reverend General Superintendent Reverend Hope. Prayer of rededication and commitment.
Let's bow our heads. Our gracious God and our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the privilege that we can approach your throne in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God, that you're God of mercy, you're God of love, you're God of grace, you're God of compassion. And God, we want to commit ourselves to you. We want to recommit our lives into your hand. God, I pray that you will rule, be king, be the Lord in our lives. Help us to indeed yield our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto you. Take our hands, take our feet, take our ears, take our whole being, Lord, as we commit our lives into your hand. We pray, God, that you will anoint us afresh with your Holy Spirit, because we have no might, we have no power of our own, but our eyes are upon you. We come against all the forces of darkness. We bind them in the name of Jesus. Every foul spirit we cast out in the name of Jesus, and we claim victory through the blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Remember those who may be going through sorrow, who may be going through pain, who may be going through various distresses. We are glad that you have said we can come boldly to the throne of grace, where we can obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. It's your grace and your mercy that has brought us through. We're living this moment because of you. And so we want to thank you and praise you too, because it's your grace and your mercy that has brought us through. We pray, God, for those who are grieving over loss of loved ones. We pray for your comfort. We pray for your peace. We pray, God, for your continued presence with them. Now you say you'll never leave nor forsake, but you'll be with us unto the end. And so, Lord, each and every one, as we bow before you, you know our need, you know our hearts, you know our desire. We pray for renewed strength in body, soul, and spirit. Give us that resolve that whatever comes our way, we will say we will go through with you. Come sorrow, come loss, or come gain, come pain, we will go through with you. Give us, oh God, that fight, to fight the good fight of faith and to lay hold on eternal life. Take thanks, God, for your blessings. Take thanks for your mercies as we commit our lives, as we commit the future into your hand. Even, Lord, as we go through various crises in the world, we know that you said you will never leave us nor forsake us, but you'll be with us unto them. So, Lord, let your abiding presence continue to be before us, back of us, beside us, beneath us, in an all wrong way. Let your presence be with us as we give you thanks. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. We want to thank our Reverend Joel Hope so much for that prayer of rededication and commitment. And at this time, we can sit and listen as we have our announcements. And these will be done via a pre-recorded presentation.
The Christian Mission Headquarters announcements for week commencing March 13th, 2022. Our theme for 2022, Looking Unto Jesus, taken from Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my buckler and the horn of my salvation and my high tower. Psalm 18, verse 2. Our first quarterly service for 2022 convenes today, Sunday, March 13th, at our Gospel Tabernacle. We extend a hearty welcome to everyone present in the sanctuary and all our faithful followers online. A warm welcome is extended to our beloved Brother Peter Lloyd from our Mount Zion Christian Mission of Panama Assembly in Brooklyn, New York. We pray that God will richly bless and edify us. We give our Heavenly Father thanks for the two candidates who were baptized yesterday at Brandon's Beach. Welcome to the kingdom for such a time as this. Let us continue to focus on the prayer points given in previous announcements and for God's divine intervention and salvation of souls in the war between Russia and Ukraine. Please be extremely vigilant in your observation of the government's COVID-19 protocols and continue fervent in prayer against the prevailing COVID-19 pandemic. Here's an opportunity for male and female members to serve. All pastors are asked to contact existing ushers from their respective churches and any other members who wish to become ushers at the Tabernacle. Please send names and telephone numbers to Sister Aileen Broom at 571-0353 or Brother Ewart Worrell at 242-8437. Our Emmanuel and Panama Christian Mission Churches of the USA and the Republic of Panama, respectively, are preparing for their centenary celebrations this year. Stay tuned for the scheduled events. Remember the sick and the shut-ins, the various ministries of the Church International, and families of the dearly departed in your prayers. Reverend Joel D. Hope, General Superintendent.
We thank the Lord for those announcements. Praise the Lord. And at this time, we are going to have a video presentation from our brother, Brother Peter Lloyd from Mount Zion Christian Mission of Panama Assembly in Brooklyn, New York. He's going to give us some greetings at this time.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. And let everything that have breath praise the name of the Lord. Thank you. God bless you. I thank you so much for that wonderful greeting. And I didn't expect to see my name up there. I'm like, wow, that's a blessing. I'm so glad that I got here somewhere near the time because the GPS was giving me a little trouble there with all the unmarked streets, but I thank God we have a good God who knows direction, right? Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not onto thine own understanding. All thy ways, acknowledge him. Come on, somebody help me. And he will direct thy path. Praise the Lord. I'm here by his direction. Thank God for that. Good morning. Good morning. I want to give a word of honor and respect to the General Superintendent of the Christian Mission, Reverend Joel Hope, and also God bless his lovely wife, who we had the privilege of meeting. Praise the Lord. Amen. I also want to give a word of honor and respect to the General Secretary, Reverend Duncan Carmichael. I want to give a word of honor and respect to the Senior Superintendent, Reverend Lennox Wiggins. I also want to give an honor, a word of respect to our General Superintendent, Reverend Dr. Alex Douglas, and the assistant superintendent, my pastor, Reverend Dr. David M. Barrow. And to all ministers, pastors, brothers and sisters, and hopefully all my friends out there, God bless you. God bless you. And we're here to lift up the name of Jesus. Amen, amen. Now, I also want to invite you all in the Christian Mission Family International to a leadership conference. This will be held in Panama from February 17th to February 21st, 2023. We are looking forward to having a wonderful time of teaching, fellowship, and receiving a great blessing from the Lord. I believe that we will leave a flyer and some more contact information will be provided for you at a later time. Now, I want to briefly tell you in the time that is allotted to me what the Christian Mission has meant to me. When I came to New York at the age of four, I came there, somebody kind of brought me there. My grandmother, Pearl Gaskin, joined our family to the Christian Mission in New York. I believe she did this because of her close relationship with the Christian Mission in Barbados. We learn to honor God in the Christian mission. We learn to study the Bible in the Christian mission. We learn to have a friend in Jesus in the Christian mission. And at the age of 14, I got baptized in the Christian mission. At the age of 15, I preached my first sermon in the Christian mission. And as I got older, I was a choir director. I've been a Sunday school teacher. I'm currently a worship leader. And several years ago, I met a beautiful, loving, caring woman named Cynthia, who I got married to. And we have been together for 15 years. And I met her in the Christian mission. So I can say with confidence, the Christian mission has been good to me. And I know there are many in this place that can say the same thing. My life has been blessed, and I have prospered by God through the Christian mission. I have come to encourage you that when you think you're not making a difference, then you are. When you think that young people do not see your commitment, they do. Many generations to come who are going to realize that their blessing and the abundant life that Jesus gave us only was available when many men and women in the Christian mission came together to pray, make financial sacrifices, build churches. We disagreed and agreed because we all came to an understanding that we simply could not follow the road that was placed before us without God's help and without each other. In order to hear, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant," we have to be doing well by God and each other. That is why the Bible says that we are to love the Lord with all our hearts and all our souls and all our minds. But it doesn't stop there. It says we are to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. Because they will truly only know that we are his disciples if we have love one for another. Thanks for this wonderful opportunity to greet you. And let us please keep all of the churches, and especially the Christian mission churches, in our prayers, knowing the difference that are making in many people's lives all over the world. God bless you.
We want to thank our brother Peter Lloyd so much for that presentation. And at this time, our Assistant General Superintendent, Reverend Lennox Wiggins, can come and give us some greetings and remarks.
Praise the Lord. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Giving honor to God, our Heavenly Father, His Son, Christ Jesus, and to the blessed Holy Spirit for another opportunity where we can assemble in His presence. And it is looking good, praise the Lord. The restrictions are moving away, praise the Lord. And God is giving us victory as we continue to reach out to Him in this COVID environment, praise the Lord. On behalf of the General Superintendent, I want to welcome and greet each and every one of you in the house today, and those of you who are online. And I want to let you know that God has been good to us. God has been good to us. And having obtained help from Him, we have continued until now. We especially greet our special guest, our brother Peter. Praise the Lord Lloyd from the Mount Zion Christian Mission Church of Panama. We are happy to have you, and also for the words of information and invitation that you have extended to us. We remember in 2019 that glorious time we had when the Christian Mission of Panama reunited again with the Christian Mission Inc. And the fellowship continues, praise the Lord. So we, as the theme song was, we're expecting great things. Praise the Lord. Let's give God a round of applause. We are expecting great things. Yesterday, we had the privilege of two candidates being baptized. Our sister Pien from the Rotdunda Church, praise the Lord. And our brother Omar Griffith from Omar Garner from the Darrow's Road Church, praise the Lord. Brother Garner is not able to make it because of work commitment, but at the towards the end of the service, we will have the reception of candidates, and our sister Payne will be received into fellowship. Praise the Lord. Let's give God a round of applause. God is still saving. Many are still being added to the church. And as we go a bit further in the program, we will recognize that our brother Peter spoke about in the Christian Mission Church and all the things that happen in the Christian Mission Church. But whenever we come to this first quarterly service in the first quarterly service at Tabernacle in Barbados Christian Mission, it is very significant for a young man who I will just ask to stand at this time. Praise the Lord. A young man, his name is Joshua. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And standing over there, his mom, Sister Karen, Joshua Bridgman, Karen Bridgman. It was 6 years ago at the first quarterly service in 2016 that a young man, a young lad, 10 years old in primary school, said to his mother, "Mom, I want to be baptized." That was 6 years ago, and it was shy of his birthday, because his birthday will be on the Thursday, which will be the 17th of March. And he is here today to give God thanks for preserving his life 6 years. 6 years, somebody give God a round of applause. For 6 years, baptized member of the church at Waterford, and he is continuing in the service of the Lord. I want to thank God for all others who have the thought process of getting baptized. Now is the time. Make much of the opportunities that are available to you. And as we continue today giving thanks and worshiping God, let us continue to do it with all of our heart, because as we see the events of time unfolding in the world calendar, we know that soon and very soon we are going to see the King. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye ready, for in such an hour you think not, the Son of Man cometh. God bless you all, and God bless us as we continue worshiping today in the house of God. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. At this time, we are going to have a special item from the Garden Christian Mission Sunday School. And then after they're finished, we will have some special prayers being given by Reverend Joan Ho. Okay? Give them a hand as they come forward.
General Superintendent Reverend Jill Hope and Mrs. Hope. The Reverend John Hope, ministers, pastors, assistant pastors, and the faithful congregation of the Christian Mission. We greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus. We are the members of the Garden Christian Mission Sunday School. I am Sayori Yearwood, and these are my sisters, Naomi and Janaya. The title of our presentation is God's Love. We will now have an excerpt from the song, The Goodness of God by C.C. Winans. This song rightly sums up God's love for us, and in return, our love for Him.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Today, our presentation will take the form of Bible verses, poems, and songs to depict God, evidence of God's love, and how we, in turn, show our love for God and the good things He has done for us and still continues to do.
St. John chapter 3, verse 16 reads, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life."
This verse is the most well-known verse in the Bible, and it is often the first verse children memorize. We Christians base our faith on this verse. He loved us enough to die for us, so that all who trust in Him will be saved from sin.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to hear me long, they are weak, but He is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
St. Matthew chapter 19, verses 13 to 14. And then again in St. Mark chapter 10, verses 13 to 15. The Bible speaks this to Jesus' love of children.
Then were they brought unto Him little children, and that He should put His hand on them and pray, and the disciples rebuked them. But Jesus said, "Suffer little children, and forbid them not to come unto me, for such is the kingdom of heaven." And He laid His hands on them.
And verses 15 of St. Mark 10, chapter 10 says, "Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein."
God's love embraces all. Through His Son Jesus, He made the lame to walk, the blind to see, the sick healed, the dumb to speak, and chase out demons from the possessed. Here is a poem that adequately tells of God's love.
God's love is like a circle big and round. And when you see a circle, no ending can be found. And so the love of Jesus goes on eternally, forever and forever. I know that God loves me.
Here are some gifts that we receive from God's love. We receive salvation. We receive forgiveness of sins.
We receive hope and strength. We receive shelter in times of trouble.
We are called from darkness into light. We now have a new family. We are included in the family of God.
We should always show our appreciation for God's love. We should always show our appreciation for the benefits we have received from God. How do we show our appreciation for God's love?
We listen to His word and walk in His footsteps. We encourage others to join the family of God.
We show kindness and generosity to those in need. We pray with and for others.
We shall show our Christian principles every day. We are the best that we can be.
Thank you, God, for caring, loving, and protecting us. We pray for the sick, the poor, the Ukrainians, and everyone on earth. May God continue to love us. In Jesus' name, amen.
We want to thank you for being a receptive congregation. We hope that the verse of a song, the line of a poem, or even a passage of scripture remains a voice in your head as you go about your daily tasks. This will be a reminder for God's love from us to you. We now invite you to sing along with us the song, I Believe, by Jonathan Nelson.
Come on, everybody, get your feet heavy. Let's go, come on.
Give them another round of applause. Amen. Praise the Lord. Our hearts were blessed. We had poems, we had prose, we had song at the end. We had a medley of talent there this morning. And we want to thank the Lord so much for those little girls and the work you all are doing at the Garden Christian Mission Church. Give yourself another hand. At this time, our Reverend Joan Hope will embark on some prayers for Joshua Bridgman. He celebrates his birthday and the anniversary of his baptism, March 2016, at age 10.
Praise the name of the Lord. I'm going to invite our brother Joshua Bridgman to stand where you can remain where you are. And I've been asked to say some special prayers as he celebrates his anniversary of baptism. Let us pray. Father, your word declares to suffer the children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. You also encourage us in the book of Proverbs 22, verse 6, to train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. This morning, Lord, we bless your holy name. Today, Lord, we give you thanks and we give you praise for the life of our brother Joshua Bridgman, a young man, Lord, who from the age of 10 committed his life into your care and keeping. And Father, I want to say, from what I've been told and the report received, you are doing a fantastic job in his life. Let us give God some praise this morning. Let us give God some thanks this morning. Father, I want to thank you, Lord, for helping little brother Joshua when he did his common entrance. As far as I have the hopefully the right information, that he was not only successful, but he gained entry to one of the second highest schools in Barbados. Let us put our hands together for our King and King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Father, when we commit ourselves into your keeping, when we dedicate our life into your care, you promise that no good thing will you withhold from those that walk uprightly. You are not only blessing Brother Joshua intellectually, but he is maturing spiritually. He is growing physically, and as we can see, what a handsome little young man he is. God, this morning I've been asked to pray for him. And so, Lord, I ask for a renewal of commitment to you, Lord. I pray, Lord, that he will become more devoted and dedicated to your service. And Lord, as he grows older and he faces the challenges that are before him, there are the challenges at school which he has to cope with. There are the challenges environmentally that he has to cope with. And you know the atmosphere in which we live, where there is that bullying in the atmosphere. All of those are challenges that our little brother Joshua has to face with. But you promise that you will keep in perfect peace those whose minds are stayed upon you. I ask for a covering for Brother Joshua. I ask that the blood of Jesus will be upon him. I ask, Lord, that you will build a hedge around him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Father, I ask that no weapon that is formed against him shall prosper. And I pray, God, that he will be successful in every area of his life. I pray also, Lord, for his lovely, attentive and kind mother who has done a fine job in taking care of him. Father, I ask that you will provide for her whatever is needed, provide for her that she will be able to take care of her son. Father, I give you thanks this morning for his life. And I ask, Lord, that as he rededicate his life to you, that you will grant him success, you will grant him favor, you will grant him prosperity. These things I ask in no other name, but in the precious name of Jesus. God bless you, Brother Joshua, and go forward knowing that the Lord of hosts is with you and the God of Jacob is a refuge. Amen. God bless you.
Amen. We want to thank our Reverend Hope so very much for those prayers. And I know truly Joshua's heart has to have been blessed, and his mom for the good job she's doing with Joshua. At this time, before we introduce our speaker, we invite our congregation to stand, and we want to sing that song, My Faith Looks Up to Thee.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, our pastoral men. And at this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you an energetic and a vibrant young man. He hails from the church at Sargent's Village Christian Mission Church. He's a man that loves God. He has a heart for the things of God. And those of you who know him, you all would know that the calling of God has been on him from his childhood until now. Without any further ado, it gives me great pleasure to have our pastor, Kenroy Marshall, speak to you. Congregation, Pastor Marshall, congregation.
Thank you so much, Dr. Marshall. Dr. Marshall, I should say. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Can we say praise the Lord today? Can we say praise the Lord today? Can we say praise the Lord? Can we say praise the Lord? If you know that 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 God have been good, that God is good, that God will be good, could you lift your hands and lift your voices and say, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Just for 30 seconds, I just want you to just engage the Lord, engage the presence of the Lord here today. I believe that the Lord is in this house. The Lord is in this tabernacle. He's descending upon us today. I believe the Lord is going to speak to us, hallelujah, from his throne. I believe he has something fresh for us today. Could you just begin to bless the Lord? If you believe today that God has something in store for you, would you just open up to the Spirit of the living God? Hey, glory to God. We worship you today. We acknowledge your presence. We acknowledge you today. We give you all honor. We give you all glory. We give you all praise today. We say, have your way today. Have your way in this house today. Have your way in this house today, God. Have your way today, God. Indeed, we need your help. I need your help today, God. Breathe the breath of life. Breathe thy breath of life in the sanctuary today, God. Let the new thing take place that have been already prophesied by the prophet Isaiah. I declare even now in this house that every spirit that is in this house, every spirit that surrounds this house is made subject to the Spirit of Almighty God. I declare even now, God, that as your word comes, it will come with power, clarity. Minds are being renewed. Lives are being changed. Hearts are being transformed according to the power of your word. You promise that your word will never return unto you void, but it would accomplish all it was sent to do. Have your way today. Hide me behind the cross today. I surrender all to you today. In Jesus' name, amen. Can we give the Lord a good praise? I give honor to the triune God today. Amen. Our general superintendent, our Reverend Hope, and his wonderful wife, our First Lady, our Reverend Joan Hope. I give honor to my wife, Amen. Hallelujah. Special lady that God have given to me. Amen. And also my support. I give honor to all of the ministers and pastors today. Amen. And I believe that God is going to speak to us today. Amen. I want to say this to you today. Even though I am in front of you and I am the humble servant today, I don't want you to see me. Don't look at me. Don't look at me. I want you to see Jesus and Him crucified. We go to Paul's letter to the church at Colossae, chapter 2. I want to read from verse 6, Colossians chapter 2. Reading from verse 6 unto 10. And when you have it, say amen. Praise God. As ye have therefore received Christ the Lord, so walk ye in him. Everybody say, walk ye in him. Rooted and built up in him, and establish in the faith as ye've been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Here comes a warning. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit after the traditions of men, after the rudiments of this world, and not after Christ. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and ye are complete in him, which is the head of all principality and power. I want to take my text from these last two verses I read. For in him, verse 9, dwells all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and ye are complete in him, which is the head, my God, of all principality and power. You may take your seat today. We have for our theme for this year, looking unto Jesus. For the next few moments, I want to minister to you on this topic. The availability of his fullness. The availability of his fullness. I want to start out by saying today that as children of the Most High God, as the church of the living God, if you are in a relationship with the Lord, then his fullness is available to you. Let me repeat that again. If you are a born-again believer, you are a part of Jesus Christ, and he is a part of you, then the fullness, his fullness, is available to you. As this scripture begins, this chapter begins, in chapter 2, there are some things that caught my attention in Paul's letter to this church at Colossae. He says that, I have great conflict for you and also the church at Laodicea.
And as I read this chapter, I came to the conclusion that there were similar characteristics between these two churches. As you would examine the church at Colossae and the church at Laodicea, it suggests to me that the same attitudes, the same operations that were at the church at Colossae was also in this church at Laodicea. Paul says, what great conflict. When I look at that word conflict, he also talks about a struggle, an inward struggle. There's a reason why he wrote this letter in such passion to this church. He says, I've learned of your steadfastness to the faith. I've learned how you would have submitted yourself to the Lord. But somewhere along the line, many of you have been distracted. Many of you have given yourselves over to other things. Many of you have allowed your focus to shift. Many of you have allowed things to cause you to be blinded. And he wrote this letter to them saying, I am reminding you, as you have received Jesus Christ the Lord, now walk in him. That suggests to me that many of these folks have stepped outside of their purpose. They would have stepped outside of their calling. They would have stepped outside of what God would have placed and invested in them. And because they would have stepped outside of that, Paul is now reminding them, if you are going to operate by the Spirit of God, if you are going to be used by the Spirit of God, if you are going to do the things that God have called you to do, you must be in him and he must be in you. There was an inward struggle. There was an inward fighting as he began to pray for this church. And I began to look through and I began to see that there are so many attitudes. I find that in the body of Christ today that there are so many bad attitudes that have shifted the focus off of God, and our focus has seemingly been shifted onto man. And no longer, many of us are not walking in Jesus. Jesus is not walking in us because we have walked outside of our purpose. We have walked outside of his will. And there is a song called today. There is a clarion call today that we ought to walk in Jesus. Beloved, I believe that we are living in a day, the church is in the church of the living God. We are in a day where we need to be walking with Jesus. Jesus ought to be walking and living on the inside of us. Now, how am I going to walk? How is my walk is going to be continually in him? Paul gives some examples. He says, this is how you are going to be, you're going to have this continual walk. And Jesus, must I say to us today that our walk must be continual. It must be perpetual. Amen. We cannot be walking with him today and not tomorrow. We cannot be walking with him yesterday and not today. We must be forever walking with Jesus. He gave some criteria how our walk is going to continue. I'm talking about the fullness of God, huh? He says in verse 7, being rooted. My God, somebody say rooted. And built up in Christ. Establish in the faith. We probably used to sing, I used to hear somebody singing that a chorus, rooted and grounded in the name of the Lord. Amen. Because if you want to get to heaven, you must be rooted and grounded. You know, one time as I was reading this scripture, when I see this, as it says, rooted and built up, I begin to think of a plant, amen, as it grows, amen, if you would send down your roots, glory to God, you watch that plant as it send down its roots, it will send up its shoots. And if you are walking in Jesus, amen, this is a criteria that you must be rooted. You must be grounded. And if the word of God is living richly on the inside of you, then you got to grow up. And hence, this is the reason why we have a lot of folk in church today that they're so confused with so many different attitudes. We got a lot of folks today in church that get so offended so fast. The spirit of offense is creeping its way and have crept its way in the house of God. And most times, let me say all the time, when we are in that place where we are so easily offended, it's so easy to miss God. It's so easy to receive. My God, you cannot receive what he's ready to pour out because you are in a place of spiritual offense. You get so easily offended. Here's what Paul continues to say in verse 8. He gives a warning, a clear warning. He says, beware. How many of you know that when you see that word beware, it's a warning? Something is up ahead. Sister McCollin, something is up ahead when you see that word, beware. Amen. He says, lest any man spoil you. Glory to God. Beware lest any man spoil you through their own philosophy. What's philosophy? What's philosophy? Men's ideologies, men's beliefs, and it's not necessarily what Jesus believed, it's not necessarily what Jesus taught, but it's what men conjure up. My God, and he says, beware lest any man spoil you. I want to stop right there. Spoilage. When we see spoil in the Bible, what does it really mean? What does it really mean? If we would think about, amen, every time that there's a battle, every time that there's a war, the individual or the team or the country who wins the war, everything that is left, all of the those persons who have been defeated, all of their possessions become spoil. Amen. If you remember in the days of Jehoshaphat, Amen. I don't really want to get into that, but I just want to bring your remembrance to something. Amen. It took the men 3 days to gather up the spoil. Must I report to you today that anytime that you're outside of the will of God, anytime that you're outside of the purpose of God, you will be gathered by spoil, by the devil himself. Amen. You are left to the mercies of the devil. And must I report to you today that the devil don't have mercy. So in this church of Colossae, there were those the Bible referred to had some itching ears. There were those, amen, they were not grounded in the faith. My God, they got outside of their calling. They got outside of their purpose. And when the strange winds blow, glory to God, they were swept away with the wind. My God, there are individuals today who are dazzling things beyond our eyes. We are hypnotized. My God, there's a spiritual hypnosis that have been going on. But I'm telling you, you will only be hypnotized when you're outside of the will and the purpose of God. These folks were at the church at Colossae. My God, we are supposed to be looking unto Jesus. This year we've been called to look unto Jesus. We've been called to look to Jesus. But when we have individuals massaging our ears. We've allowed individuals to massage our ears and tell us all fancy things that are not of God. We may think that they're of God. We've gone along with the strange winds. Paul gives a clarion call. Beware! My God, I'm saying to Christian Mission today, beware! Beware! Lest any man spoil you through their philosophy, their vain deceit, after the traditions of men. Must I also submit to you today? It's all right to have traditions, but let me tell you something. Anytime that our traditions get into the way of God, anytime that our traditions, amen, does not line up to the word of God, let me tell you, we are in some serious trouble. Amen. I tell you, I'd rather obey God than to obey a man. If God said it, we ought to, line up with the word of God. Let me tell you something, beloved. If we are going to be effective as a church today, we must be in total submission to the Lord. If we are going to receive what God have available for the church of the living God today, we must submit ourselves to his command. Jesus must still be our commander in chief. Do I have any witnesses out there with me today? Amen. Are you out there with me today? Jesus is still Lord. He must still be our commander in chief. Now, I like this part. It goes on to say, he's after the rudiments of the world and not after Christ. My God, listen, beloved. The world, the governments in the world must be following the lead of the church and not in the opposite direction. Anybody hear what I just said? Did you hear me? The world, the governments of the world, they're supposed to take lead of the church of the living God and not in the opposite. Very often, we are seeing it and the opposite. Because we have become so compromising. My God, I don't want to be a target, Pastor Deborah. So let me go along. Let me go along with what they're saying. My God, I don't want to be a target. So I prefer to remain quiet. Because if I remain quiet, they can't see my face. They can't hear my voice. But I want to tell you today that it's time that the body of Christ, the church of the living God, my God, get the fire of God. My God, stop being so compromising. Get some fire in your eyes, some fire in your mouth. Put some pep in your step. Glory to God. Amen. Listen, it is time that the church of God live on the offensive rather than the defensive. You want to understand? I want us to understand today that God have whatever it takes for us. He have it in abundance. He have it in his fullness. My God, and you know what? It never go wasted. It's there in, Sister Ingrid, it's there in abundance for us. And all we need to do is to tap in. All we need to do is to be in the place to receive. Anybody want to receive from God today? Anybody want to receive from the hand of Almighty God? It's already there available for us. God is ready to descend. He's ready to pour out. He's ready to pour out. Now, he says, verse 9, for in him, in Christ, dwells all of the fullness. When you view Jesus Christ, you are looking at fullness, beloved. When you look at the Godhead, you're looking at fullness. Amen. As a matter of fact, let me just say this. The Apostle Peter says, hallelujah, that he have given us all things that pertains to life and godliness, everything that we need to live in this life. Amen. He has it available. Amen. And I'm telling you that God is not a stingy God. Amen. God, he's a good giving God. He knows how to give good gifts. Amen. And he has it in abundance. He's ready to lay it on us today. But let me tell you something. We must be in the place. We must be in the place to receive what God is ready to pour out. He got it in abundance. Somebody say he has it in abundance. Let me tell you something. For the main fact that God have called you, he has what it takes to equip you. And if God have called you, Reverend Seeley, amen, if God have called you, he will equip you. God don't pick up a wine and send him to war and then got tools. Not take up a man. As a matter of fact, let's look in the natural. Which army, which general sends out an army without artillery? Man, you're going to, my God, you're going to commit suicide. You're going to commit suicide. And let me tell you something, God don't commit suicide. He never will. Hallelujah. Amen. If God have called us, beloved, if God has called us, he will equip us. Amen. He has what it takes. So some of us today, we need more anointing. That's available. Some of us need more power. That's available. Some of us need deliverance. That's available. Some of us need healing. That's available. Whatever you need today, he has it available. It's in his fullness. Somebody shout fullness. Somebody shout fullness. Oh, glory to God. You know, I like this part. in verse 11. Saints, that the fullness of God is in bodily form. Verse 11 goes on to say, and ye, I want to put we, I want to put I. We are complete in him. This is his fullness. So when the anointing of God, when the fullness of God comes upon a man, amen, nothing is missing. Glory to God, nothing is broken. You are complete. That man is complete. I don't know about you, but I'm complete in Jesus today. Can somebody confess with me today? I am complete. I'm complete in Jesus. Now, if these folks were really walking with the Lord, walking in his fullness, there would have been no need for Paul to write such a letter telling them to beware. And as I continue to analyze this letter, in Paul's closing remarks, if you would just flip over with me to chapter 4 and verse 16. Chapter 4 and verse 16, it says, and when this epistle is read among you, cause that it be also read. Cause it to be also read in the Laodicean church. And that ye likewise read the epistle from Laodicea. My God. Now, let me get some things here right now. Oh my God. Now, if you would remember that there was a man called John who was banished. And when you hear that word banish, it's a word of separation. He was banished away on an island. The Bible calls it the Isle of Patmos. And even although he was in a place where he was cut off and exiled, thank you, sis, banishment. You know what, Reverend? They could not separate him from God's fullness. And because he had access to the divine, because he was in a place where he could receive from God, God gave him the revelations, light revelation, and he was able to write the book of Revelation. What I'm saying, beloved, he wrote to some churches and to the angel of the church at Laodicea. He wrote and he said, I know your works, for you are neither hot nor cool. And I am ready to spew you out of my mouth. That sounds to me like a compromising church. That sounds to me like a church that was unstable. That sounded to me as a church that went their own way and just do whatever they feel like doing. And God says, through the man of God, John, I am about to spill you out of my mouth. A church that had access to God's fullness. They have lost their focus. They have lost, my God, their ground. They had itchy ears. They would have listened to other individuals rather than to listen to God. And God says, in this season, those of you who are in a lukewarm state, in a compromising state, I am ready to spit you out. It is still applicable today. My God, it is still applicable today. We are in that compromising state. We are in that lukewarm state. And God says, I'm about to clean the house. And when I clean the house, and this is a very serious word, beloved, when I clean the house, another will take your place. Those who are ready, those who are willing to submit themselves to the, oh my God, the divine authority of the Lord. Those who will do my will. Those who will do my pleasure. Those whom I will use. And let me tell you something. The same functions, the same operations that were going on in the church at Laodicea was going on in the church at Colossae. And this is the reason why Paul said to Colossae, see to it that you read their epistle and the epistle that I send them, you read it too. Let it be read in this church. I'm saying to this house today, I'm saying to this house that we are in a place, we are living in a day where God have called us, amen, into a place where we must realign ourselves, change our focus, change our direction, glory to God, amen, change what you've been operating in. Must I say to you that what you've been operating in is still, my God, what you've been operating in is old. God says, I'm ready to do a new thing. Don't you know, you don't know it? I'm ready to do something fresh. I got my fullness. My fullness is ready. Let me tell you something today. If you are not ready today, God is going to bypass you. You're going to be left by the wayside. Because many of us, I am very sorry to say today, but if you are outside of the will of God, if you are outside of God's covenant today, amen, you are outside of God's covering. And let me say this to you, anytime that you are outside of God's covering, anytime that you're outside of God's covenant, anytime that you're outside of His will, He is not responsible for you. He is not responsible for you. And let me tell you something. We got to get it right. We must get it right. We must get it right. I'm very serious today because this is a serious word from the Lord today. Hey, listen, His fullness is available to us, but only those, amen, only those that are connected to the divine today will receive. And here, the reason why some of us not receiving I just want to echo some words of our dear brother, Carlos Hall. He spoke to us a few weeks back. And what a heavy charge that was laid upon the church. I said, my God. A heavy charge that was laid upon the church. That when we are supposed to be looking unto Jesus, we are busy looking for Jesus. Oh my God. Now, if I'm sure that many of you, if you did not hear that message, you would have missed it. You would miss what I just said. Amen. Amen. And I'm telling you, many of us, We spend so much time. Listen, we have lost our focus. We have lost our way. So we got to, listen, we have lost sight of Jesus. So we got to be looking for him. And you know what? Jesus right in front of us though. But you know what? Because there's no spiritual connection. My God, because we are walking our own way. Because, amen, we have followed other doctrines. Everybody got their own doctrine. But let me tell you something. We need to follow the doctrine of Jesus Christ. We got to follow the doctrine of Jesus Christ. And anytime that we are outside, and we are outside following our own thing, we've lost our vision, we've lost our purpose, we've lost our focus, then we gotta waste time looking for Jesus. My God, you know why we have lost sight? Because we've been found, we've been caught in compromising states. Here's it, beloved. God is calling all of us today. Shall we stand to our feet? God is calling all of us today to move away from our lukewarm state. Move away from our bad attitudes. Listen, I want to report to you today. Here's the reason why we need to do that. Because God is doing a new thing, as I aforesaid. And I don't know about you, but I choose to be a part of the new move of God. I'm a part, listen, I choose. I make the decision today to go God's way. We have any persons today who are in this house that choose to go God's way? Anybody choose to walk in the Lord today? Anybody choose to be made complete in Jesus today? Anybody out there? Anybody out there choose to walk in God's fullness? It's available to us. It's available to me. And I receive your word today. I receive your fullness. God, I recognize that you want to do a new thing in me. I recognize that you want to do a new thing through me. And God, I choose to be your conduit today. I choose to be your instrument today. Anybody making that conscious decision today? Lord, I choose you. Lord, I choose to walk in you. Lord, I choose to receive your fullness that is available to me. God, I want to be what you've called me to be. As a matter of fact, I will be what you've called me to be. My God, your Lord, I say yes. I say yes to your will. Yes to your way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so I prophesy over this congregation today. I prophesy over this church. The Christian mission. My God, that we shall walk in the Lord. We shall walk in Jesus. We shall not be compromising. We will be open to the Spirit of God in this season. Our ears, our eyes will be open. I come against the spirit of stubbornness, that one-way spirit. I declare that we shall be in the place to receive all that God have in store for us. We will meet our mark in this nation of Barbados. We will become the voice that God have given. I prophesy a new day. A new day. A new day. A new day over this organization. We will be submissive. We will be submissive to our commander-in-chief. We will be led by the Spirit of the living God. Father, I pray over this congregation. Oh, glory, oh, look, glory, oh, glory. I come against that spirit of disobedience. I come against that spirit of disobedience. God, where we are walking according to our own wills, I come against it. I declare, oh God, that we will align our lives to your way and to your will. God, we will march to the beat of your drums. We will align ourselves with what you are doing and what you are seeing now. I declare, oh my God, that we will not be in a state of compromisation, but we will stand as the faithful warriors that you have called us to be in this time and in this season, as we continue to look to you. God, whatever today that your people stay in need of, grant it unto them. And as the faithful God you are, let healing, deliverance be manifested. Oh my God, my God, my God, my God. Right across this nation of Barbados and wherever the Christian mission is today, Lord, let fresh operations take place. God, where we can once again see miracles, we can once again see deliverance, we can once again see healing, demonstrations of your anointing in every mission station today, God. In the name of Jesus, the north, the south, the east, the west, my God, my God, my God, let your anointing hit this entire island, God. And in Guyana, in Panama, in the U.S., my God, even in Trinidad, we declare a freshness. Let it be so. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you.
Hallelujah.
want to thank our pastor, Ken Roy Marshall, so very much for that word, encouraging us to serve the Lord in spirit and in truth. And at this time, our Reverend Duncan Carmichael, the General Secretary, is going to come and introduce the candidates. And then this will be followed by our Pastor Orrin Lynch into our communion service. Reverend Duncan Carmichael.
Thank you. We have today to receive us two candidates that were baptized yesterday afternoon. One candidate is absent today, she can't make it. But we're thankful to God that the other one can make it. And we want to congratulate them. We want to continue to pray for them that God will keep them in His will. The name of that candidate is Sister Karen Payne from the Rock Dunder Assembly. The other candidate was Omar Garner from Darius Road, but said that he can't make it today. I pray that God will continue to bless them in there.
Lord, shall we bless the Lord? Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together. We give God thanks for this opportunity to be able to welcome into the family of God our sister Karen Payne. Praise the Lord. Give God a round of applause. A decision that was made to follow Jesus. And we are often aware that there's rejoicing in heaven over one soul. Yesterday, she was received and entered into the waters of baptism, along as was mentioned earlier, Brother Omar Garner from the Darius Hill Church, Darius Road Church, but he's not here at present. So, Sister Karen, it gives me great pleasure on the behalf of the General Superintendent, the Board of Management of the Christian Mission Church, to invite you and welcome you into the family of God. The decision that you have made is indeed a great one, but rest assured, you will not be alone because you have the support of your brothers and your sisters, not only in Barbados, but across the region of the world. And my encouragement to you, my beloved daughter, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know, your labor shall not be in vain. Welcome into the family of God. God bless you. Yes, thank you. Let's give her another round of applause. And I turn the proceedings back over to our moderator.
At this time, Pastor Orrin Lynch is going to come and he will be conducting the communion service. Pastor Orrin Lynch.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Let's bless the Lord. Just lift your hands and give him some glory and some praise. Amen. Hallelujah. I promise you we're not going to be extremely long in this segment of our service. Greetings to the ministerial brethren. Greetings to all of you. Greetings to those who may be watching us online, whether it be YouTube or whether it be Facebook or otherwise. We greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we declare his lordship and his glory. Amen. Congratulations to those two candidates, the young lady here and the young man who were baptized yesterday and now are a formal part of our congregation and our church. Blessings upon you all in Jesus' name. I want to invite at this time as a start to have the worship team come, and they're going to, I want us to engage in the first song, I Will Praise Him. We're going to do the first two verses of that song, I Will Praise Him.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. I will praise him.
Crystal fountain open wide for all my sins, I obey the Spirit wooing when he saw me with me. I will praise him, I will praise him, praise the loud voice in her. Give him glory, all ye people, for his light has washed away his sin. Though the way seems straight and narrow, all I claim was swept away. My ambitions, plans, and
thank you so much. We will praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Please stand to your feet as we read a few verses from the 26th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew. We're going to pick up the reading at the 26th verse, and we're going to go through to the end, the 30th verse. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 26, from the 26th verse. It reads, "And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it, and broke it, and gave it to the disciples, and said, Take, eat, this is my body. And he took the cup, and gave thanks, and gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of it. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. But I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. And when they had sung a hymn, they went out into the Mount of Olives. Then said Jesus unto..." Well, we paused there at verse 13. My apologies. We'll stop there at verse 30. That sets out what is before us today. Please take your seats. we have come to a juncture in our service that can arguably be considered the most important part of our service. Arguably because there are many who think that the way our services are constructed, we sing and we dance and we testify, etc. Then we come to the Word, and we like to describe that segment where the Word is preached as being the most important. But we have settled before us today, we are at a point that we call the Lord's Supper. We are sitting around what is considered the Lord's table, and it has been given many different names. It is called Holy Communion, it's called the Lord's Supper, it's called Breaking of Bread, and if we are of a particular affiliation, we may even call it the Holy Eucharist. Jesus sat with his disciples as he celebrated the Feast of the Passover, or the Feast of Unleavened Bread. And he gave specific instructions, or he lay out before us, as we have still available to us, he has laid out the importance, the profound significance of what we are about to engage in. I therefore say that, as is known to us all, we dare not take what we are going to engage in lightly. Amen? It is one of the primary sacraments or ordinances of the New Testament church. And Jesus said, as often when he spoke through the Apostle Paul in the 11th chapter of 1 Corinthians, at the 23rd verse following, going on, he said, as often as we do it in remembrance of him. I therefore suggest to us today that what we engage in here now is profoundly important. It is how we keep alive as believers. Amen? When we engage in the two components, we break the bread and we partake of it, and then we drink or sip the wine representative of his blood. These are two important components in our salvation. For without them, there really is nothing for us to hang on to. I welcome those today who may be somewhat uninitiated, meaning it's the very first time that they're going to be partaking. We welcome you. But for us to understand that it is important for us, there are those churches or those administrations that may do it every week. There are those who may do it every quarter. We, in our mission, we tend to do it every month. If we're told to do it as often, then it could hardly be considered often if we practice once every year. And there are those of us, when we come, or when it comes to our service of communion, the word communion suggests coming together. It comes from a Latin word which means sharing in common, coming together. The Greek version is the same word we use, and is translated fellowship. That is, we bind ourselves together. One of the things that when we engage in communion it does is that it makes us to be with several hundreds of believers across the face of the planet that we may not have ever met. We may not know them. But the fact that we engage in what we are going to engage in, and the fact that they do it, it pulls us together as one. Beloved, we have Christian believers, and I know recently we have been praying for them, those in Ukraine and Russia, etc. They are all across the face of the world. But we unite with them in remembering the fact that Jesus died so many years ago on Calvary's cross. It is an act of faith. There is not a single one of us here who can raise our hands and say, I was there when Jesus was crucified. I was there when that soldier pushed that spear in his side and forthwith came blood and water. We were not there, but we believe. And Jesus said to his disciples in Matthew and elsewhere, when you do this, this is representative of what I have suffered for you. When he did it with them in Matthew 26, he had not yet died. But he died thereafter. His body was broken. His blood was shed for our redemption and our salvation. The Bible declares that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. Well, what the bread does, the blood, the bread and the wine that are used, these are symbolic. There are those denominations, those administrations that would suggest to us that when we take that bread and we take that wine, that they are, in fact, the body and the blood of Jesus. No, they're not. No, they are not. They are representations. They are symbols. Amen? So, of course, because of the times in which we live, it has been very difficult to engage in what we traditionally engage in, breaking of bread. I like that. It is so symbolic. But we have now moved away, and we have to resort to methods and means that are a little more cosmetic, a little more pleasing when it comes to health issues, etc. So we have wafers. They are representative of the blood of the. This is representative of the body, the broken body of our Lord Jesus. And his body was broken, that mine and yours. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Don't have to be broken. Or better yet, that when our bodies are broken by sickness, by ailment, by whatever, that we can receive a healing, a blessing. I want to say to you today, matter-of-factly, that the broken body of Jesus, when we partake in this representative form, what it does for us is it brings healing to us. Somebody raise your hand and give God some glory and some praise. And we have preached already, so I'm not preaching, just sharing a few points with you. Secondly, the blood of Jesus, representative in the wine that we partake of, that's symbolic of him shedding his blood. Where in Hebrews we are told, without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. If there is no remission, then there is no forgiveness. Because forgiveness is founded on the notion of remission. Remission means to send back. In the Old Testament under that time, you know the priests, when they're engaged, one of the acts they would do is to lay their hands upon a goat that was called the scapegoat, and they would symbolically pass those sins onto that goat, and that goat would be banished into exile somewhere in some wilderness. But Jesus came, amen, so that our sins can be removed from us as far as the east is from the west. Aren't you glad for that? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I want to say today, let me just briefly explain to you this concept of remission. I share it with my congregation all the time. If you do not have, if you picked up yourself tomorrow and you went to First Caribbean International and you said, I want to withdraw some money. And the teller asks, well, okay, no problem. You get your name and so on. But you said to them, but I don't have an account here. You know, they're more than likely not to just call the police, but probably call the other van from down Black Rock to get you. Because you're attempting to withdraw where you have not set up an account. This is exactly what remission is. Remission is setting up the account with God. After you have opened your account, you may do your withdrawals and your deposits. Are you with me? So when Jesus' blood was shed, he set that act up that we all could open our accounts with him so that we could continually have what? Forgiveness of sins. Are you with me? We give God thanks today. And I want to close in my brief little bit with you here today to say this, that the broken body and the blood of Jesus, represented in the wafer we are going to use, represented in the wine we are going to drink, are still efficacious. Now, all that word means is that they are still effective for what they were intended in the first place. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad? And with that in mind, here's what I want us to do. That today, when we take that wafer, don't think of it lightly, but to take it and to say to yourself, in this I am receiving my healing. You have respiratory problems because of whatever. You have stomach problems. You have all this. But listen, when that wafer passes your tongue, your throat then goes down. Amen? It's doing some business in our bodies. Amen? We have got to, by faith, believe it. Receive your healing today. Receive your healing today. Receive your healing today. And if you're standing proxy for somebody else, receive that healing on their behalf as well. That when you take that wafer, God is going to do for you just what it was intended. That our broken bodies can be made whole. And then when you take that wine, know that that is going to take care of all your sins. Lord, I thank you that through this I can have forgiveness. I thank you that through this I can be made clean. I thank you that through your blood that was shed, I am saved. I'm a new person. And Lord, let it serve to clean me out and to make me what I should be today. Stand to your feet, would you? Hallelujah. Before I ask blessing, I'm going to have the team to raise that song, The Blood That Jesus Shed For Me. So we're going to sing that. And while we do this, it's my understanding that everyone who's going to take part would have already received your little packet. If you have not done so, and you want to engage with the ushers to get yours, please do so. I just want to sing this a couple of times, and then when I come back, I'm going to ask a blessing on them, and we're going to partake.
Hallelujah. The blood that Jesus shed for me, way back on Calvary, the blood that gives me strength from day to day, it shall never
shall never lose its power, for it reaches to the highest mountain.
Yes, it does.
And it flows to the lowest valley. Shall never lose its power, for it reaches to the highest mountain.
promise rang from day to day. It shall never lose its power.
Hallelujah. Shall never lose its power. Hallelujah.
Bless God. Take your little pocket and just do like this. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you at this precious hour, and we give you thanks for giving us your Son Jesus. We declare your awesome power. We declare his lordship in this our space, even now. Take, Father, these wafers. Take this wine. Sanctify them that they may serve the very purpose of which they are here. They were bought and brought, Lord, that we may come together and celebrate, God, and remember the fact that you died for us. Your body was broken. Your blood was shed. And now for all the blessings that can accrue to us, we ask that you'd open heaven and bless us as we partake. Sanctify them that they may serve us, not just spiritually, but the extent maybe that in our physical selves, there would also be a difference. We pray and we give you thanks. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. All the people amen. Say, amen. Now amen. I think you're going to have to take your seats for the remainder. So I want to, those at home who may be watching us and are partaking with us, you have to be a little careful with the packet. There is a thin film that if you make, you're going to try really hard, peel back that very thin film. All is well, amen? In Jesus' name, praise God. Just peel back the thin film to expose the wafer, and we're going to wait on each other so you can take it out. Everybody's ready? If you're not ready, say amen. Then we all are. Let's partake together in Jesus' name. We give God thanks for his broken body, amen, that makes ours whole. All right. Now if you would peel back the rest of the covering very carefully, not to spill it. Again, we're going to wait for each other. And again, if you're not ready, can I hear a loud amen? Okay, so everybody's ready. Let's partake together. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Those simple two acts mean so much. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody say amen.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, I've received a blessing.
I've received a blessing.
Yes, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Thank God. Thank God for the opportunity. Cherish it. Amen. God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Please stand. We are going to have the final verses of the first song we sang, I Will Praise Him. And so the worship team is going to take the lead here again. We thank them very much.
Amen.
Glory to him.
away my sin. Blessed be the name of Jesus. I'm so glad he took me in. He forgave my transgression. He has cleansed my heart from sin. I will praise him. I will praise him. I will praise him. Praise the Lamb for sinners still. Give him glory, all ye people, for his blood has washed away my sin. Glory, glory to the Father. Glory, glory to the Son. Glory, glory to the Spirit. Glory to the Great One. I will praise him. Give him glory, all ye people, for his blood has washed away my sin. I will praise him. I will praise him. Praise the Lamb for sinners stained. Give him glory, all ye people, for his blood has washed away my sin. I will praise him. I will praise him. Praise the Lamb for sinners stained. Give him glory, all ye people, for his blood has washed away. I will praise him. I will praise him. Praise the Lamb for sinners stained. Give him glory, all ye people, for his blood has washed away his sin.
Hallelujah.
God bless you.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Back over to our dear sister, Marcia.
Amen. Hallelujah. I will praise him. I will praise him. Praise the Lamb for sinners slain. Give him glory, all ye people, for his blood can wash away each stain.
We've come pretty much to the end of our service. Just before we do, I want to thank you for your participation in the last part of the service. Thanks to the worship team. They deserve a rousing round of applause. They did a wonderful job just now. Some of you may have noticed that our Dr. Marsha, slipped just now. And so I want to nullify any impact. Amen? Anybody here with me today? I want you to point your hand in her direction. Yes, Sister Marcia, I just want to ask you to put your hand on your hip. Let's pray together in Jesus' name. Father, even now as a point of contact, Father, all the saints of God are pointing in Marcia's direction. Her hand is on her hip as a point of contact. We thank you today because every impact of that fall has now been nullified in the name of Jesus. We take authority. We take authority over every demonic fashion, everything that the devil would want to bring. We declare him a liar. We declare him a deceiver. And we say he has lost one more time. And we thank you for touching her body and for healing her. And so we feel assuredly today by your faith that she would suffer no impact of that fall that she just suffered. We thank you, we bless you, and we honor you as we commit her to you. In Jesus' name, all the people say amen and amen and amen. God bless you.
I want to thank our Pastor Lynch for that prayer. And at this time, we're going to have our Reverend Carmichael. He will give us some additional announcements.
Before the last prayer is offered, I would like to inform you that Miss Martin, that lives over the other side of the road, passed away. And the funeral will be here on Thursday morning at 10 o'clock. So any of you who can make it, that funeral, can do so. Thank you.
Amen. At this time, we're going to have our Reverend Frank Walcott, and he is going to come and give us the closing prayer and bless the offering. Reverend Walcott.
Sovereign God and Father, this afternoon, our Lord, as we stand in your presence, Lord, we want to give you a high note of thanks and praise for bringing us safely into your house of worship another time. Lord, we thank you. Thank thee, Lord, for the man servant who's delivered your word. We thank you, want to give you, Lord, thanks and praise for what thou has enabled us to achieve this afternoon in your house of worship. We ask you, God, that you will continue to remember us. Remember this little Christian Mission Church as we stand here on this earth, Lord, I'm asking you that every member, Lord, you will remember. Every heart, Lord, you will rekindle and that you will continue, Lord, to bless this noble organization and all the other churches that are lifting up your holy name. I'm asking you, Lord, that your presence will always be with us and that you will always remember us, even, Lord, when our strength fails. Even when we seem to be giving up, that you, Lord, will always be there for us. Bless what have we achieved here today. Lord, we know we have achieved much from your word. In many sounds, Lord, we have achieved many things from them. And everything that was said and done here in your presence today, we have truly enjoyed ourselves in your presence. Now, Lord, we're asking you that you'll take us to our homes of abode in peace and in safety. And that you will remain with us through the remainder of the day. And beyond that, Lord, you remain with us through the remainder of our days. Take thanks for everything, Lord. These mercies I'm asking in no other name, but in the name of your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.